So something that I wanted to really talk about real quick here is how I set up my stream. I know that I haven't been streaming for too long, but you know, I had to kind of figure it out how to do it myself, especially if I'm streaming from the console. And when I went onto YouTube to try and figure out a way how to do that, I couldn't figure it out. It took me a while to get it done the way I did, so I'm going to show you the quickest way now. On console, obviously, you can download Twitch and broadcast from your console through there, which, you know, that works fine. But you also want to do things like control scenes, like starting soon screen or a be right back screen or an ending screen or whatever. And you can't really do that on the console. You can only do that through Twitch Studio on the PC. So I'm going to show you a quick way that I do it. It's the easiest way that I know how to do it. I know there's probably way better ways with Streamlabs or however anybody else uses it. But this is how I do it. So basically what I do... So right now you're seeing my Twitch Studio from PC. Well, this is only going to work if you have a PC, because you need to be able to install the Xbox console companion, which you see down here. I already have it open. Once you download the console companion, you just log in with your Xbox credentials and whatnot. You go down to connection. You're going to see this right here. You're going to see your console, and you're just going to hit connect. Then it'll give you the option to stream. Not a whole lot of people use the built-in Xbox stream thing, but at the very least, it's useful for this. So what you're going to do next is hit stream. Continue. Okay, so what you're seeing now is my actual Xbox home screen, real time. Maybe there's a half second delay. And as you can see, the video quality is actually pretty good. So once you've started doing that, you're going to want to go back to Twitch Studio. And you're going to want to change this part up here, the main screen share. You're going to see that it appeared on the Xbox console companion. Go to that, next, and I don't know why it appears as this with these weird tags. I have no idea why that is. Okay, so now you can control your stream from your Twitch Studio on your PC. You can switch to your other cards here like you normally would. And the only thing that you're going to have to do that's going to be kind of a little bit annoying is you're going to want to stay in main while you're playing, and you're going to have to stay on the Xbox console companion window open, because if you don't, what'll happen is whatever the last image that was seen on this screen will stay frozen on your Twitch Studio as that. So you can probably hear me moving around on the console right now, but you're not seeing any changes on the screen. It means that you can only do this if you're on the console companion, so you're gonna have to stay in this window, and then it'll switch. If you want to make any quick switches, just hit Alt Tab to switch real quick. Then you switch to any of your cards, and then you can switch back to the main and then go back to full screen on the console companion. So that's the easy way, the easiest way that I've found doing that. And then Yeah, so what I do is I usually do it that way, and if I want to see a chat, I'll just open up my phone and open the Twitch stream management thing on the phone and just watch my chat through there. But that's the easiest way that I know to get your console onto your Twitch Studio and be able to control it from the Twitch Studio on the PC. And I think that'll about do it. Thanks for watching. Take it easy.